Hello, my name is Keith Hill and I'm with Omron Automation and Safety. Today's video is going to demonstrate how to use the anti-chatter void prevention option using our F3SG global safety light curtain and our F3W muting sensors. Right now, since I don't know how the unit was set up before, I'm going to come up here and I'm going to log in. And I'm going to go to the administrative level, and I will choose the password is default, which is 4 zeros. So I'll enter that, and I'll click OK. We'll give the software a couple seconds, and we'll come up to our recovery, and we'll click on that, and then we'll click on reset to factory default settings. We'll give the software a couple seconds. And you'll notice that it'll give us an indication down here that it was successful. All right, now that we've done that, we'll go back to the top of the page and we'll come down to muting slash override. All right, within this screen, we do have the ability to use this up here to zoom in if we want to zoom in on any particular beams, or we can zoom back out. We also do have the ability to select or change the axis down here to number of beams or sensor length in millimeters. In this case, I'll just keep it in number of beams. We also show where our muting zone is. Presently, right now, it's set up for all 16 beams, so we will shorten that shortly. We do also, up in this area of the graph, we're able to see what's physically going on while we're using an automatic teach-in function. We'll be able to visually see how many beams are being blocked by our object. All right, so now since I do have my object in the beam presently, I'm going to go and use the teach-in function. Where before on the other videos we showed how to manually set up, this one I'm going to go and show the teach-in. Now since we're using the F3W muting sensors, the first thing we're going to need to do is first make sure that we do have muting enabled, and then we'll have to use this pull down and select exit only muting, and that's because we are using the F3W muting sensors. All right, within there we're going to go in and we're going to go and select teach in, and that will visually show us how many beams are being blocked by our object. So right now I physically have 3 beams being blocked. So I'm going to go in and I'm going to confirm this zone by clicking on confirm zone. And you'll see it shortened our muting zone to only 3 beams right at the present time. All right, the other thing we're going to need to do is that's basically all you need to do for the muting option. Now we're going to come up to the top of the page. And since we did change the unit back to factory default with the newer F3SG demo kits, we will have to set the lamp settings to be correct. So we'll come back up here, we'll log in, we'll go to administrative levels and enter in the 4 zeros and say OK. And then we'll select lamp setting option. Here, if you're not sure if you do have the older firmware in your global light curtain, it's good just to verify this because we will download all this to the light curtain when we're ready. So what we're going to need is for the auxiliary output, we do need to make sure that muting override information is selected. We do want to make sure disable is selected and on one time. For our priority 2, we're going to use this pull down and we're going to do muting slash override information, and we'll select that. We do want to make sure that it is set up for disable, and then output pattern we're going to select to be on one time. For our priority 1 settings, I'm going a little bit out of whack here, but We're going to set this up for safety output information. So we'll use the pull down. We'll scroll all the way up, and it's the first selection available to us. We'll make sure that the inverted signal output is enabled and that we have it set for solid on. All right, for our last setting, priority 3, we'll use the same selection safety output information. So we'll use this pull down. We'll scroll all the way up to the top and select safety output information. We'll make sure this is set up for disable. And we'll use this pull down to select solid on. Okay, now we've got all done that, we need to go and write the configuration to the light curtain. So we'll come up, we'll click on that icon. It'll bring us the write information screen, and we'll click on the write. We'll give the software a couple seconds, and it will indicate that it did write the parameters to the light curtain. Okay, now we'll go live and show you how to demonstrate using the anti-chatter void prevention option using the F3SG safety light curtain. I've gone and created an object that has several holes in it to demonstrate the anti-chatter void prevention option using our F3SG global safety light curtain and our F3W muting sensors. Now basically right now I have all of the dip switches in the off condition, so I'm not using the feature at this moment because I want to demonstrate how it can mess with the light curtain with these various different holes in the product. So if you come in through, and if you notice on sensor, both sensor A and sensor B, as I come through with the object, you'll see them turning on and turning off. Right as the object enters the muting field, it trips the light curtain because it didn't get the correct timing to satisfy the light curtain. I'll put it through one more time. And immediately, boom, because it's turning on and turning off. So now I'm going to go and I'm going to turn power off to the light curtain, because you do not want to do any dip switch settings with the F3SG or the F3W muting sensor with power on. So I turn power off, and I'm going to come in and I'm going to enable dip switch number 2 only. The reason for that is my holes are not that big in the object. Otherwise, if my holes were larger, I may also have to use the other dip switches for the off delay to increase the amount of time that the sensor A and sensor B are on, thus eliminating the larger holes in the object. So right now, since I turned on dip switch number 2, I'm going to come and turn power on. I'll let it stabilize. And now, if you watch sensor A and sensor B indications, they're on all the time through the curtain, allowing me to pass the object through. Even if I come in here and I go back and forth for the anti-chatter, it still goes through with no problem. So that shows how you can demonstrate the anti-chatter void prevention using our F3SG global safety light curtain and our F3W muting sensors. Thank you very much for your time, and have a great day.